Hi guys, just a quick video working with WinCC Projects. I'm going to show you how to back up your project and change your WinCC project name. So let's get started. First, if WinCC Explorer is running, you can deactivate right from the toolbar. We see that this project is in runtime because we see active up here, and also the deactivate button is enabled. Looking at runtime, this particular project does have a stop runtime button, so we could stop it here and we'll wait for it to deactivate. Once we're out of runtime, you could either hit the X up here in the top right corner or do File, Close, or Exit. If you use the Exit feature, it's going to ask you if you want to close the project when exiting. You have to do this because you cannot archive a project if runtime is running or if the project is opened. It leaves the databases attached to SQL Server and they cannot be copied into an archive. So we'll make sure this is checked and just hit Exit. Once the project is closed, you are going to go look up Project Duplicator, and this comes with WinCC, all versions. We're going to just select our source project. My project, WinCC V8, is in the normal WinCC Projects folder, and we're just going to select the MCP file, that's your project file, and I will click Open. And if I want to change the name, then you can use Save As. You can just give it a new name. Now, notice that the default folder that the project duplicator comes up with is in the actual project directory that we want to duplicate and archive. So we don't want to do that. So really important tip, make sure you create a whole new project folder. And I'll just call this WinCC V8 backup and hit save. Now it'll save the project and you should see a success folder. We'll just click OK and close. Now if we want to open the backup, I'll open up WinCC. And it's going to open the last project that we had open. So we'll just do File Open. And here's our backup. Notice that our MCP file has been renamed along with all the project databases. And you'll see that our project has a new name. Okay, a couple of notes. Make sure you close your project first correctly. If you're in runtime, you've got to stop runtime and close the project or you can't archive it. Use the Project Duplicator app to archive and change the name if you want. And make sure you create a new project directory so you're not archiving in your old project. If you like this video, give us a like and a subscribe. Share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.